Hi guys! Today we're picking up where we left off before. We're just waving goodbye to this nice kid who was stalk watching with us in the last video. We're heading back down the road from Nyamirambo Panorama, but we'll be turning off for Gikondo before we reach the centre. Nyamirambo Stadium on the left. Field. If you want to know about the history of that, check out my previous motor ride through Nyamirambo. Banana beer, I mentioned the nuns who used to make banana beer in Nyamirambo. I kind of feel like they used to be somewhere around here. I love this. Traditional imigongo art right next to a very modern Coke advert. You'll see a lot of adverts for Mutzig beer. There used to only really be two main beers in Rwanda, Mutzig and Primus, and you used to be in one camp or the other. I was always a Mutzig girl. But the beer companies sponsor a lot of signs for restos and cafes. Sometimes you don't notice the actual name of the place because you think it's just a beer advert. So here we're turning off from the main drag and heading to Gikondo. This is one of my favourite roads in the city, especially at night time. Because Kigali is spread over a lot of hills, it looks amazing at night with all these twinkling lights in the dark. And this particular bend in the road is beautiful. It always reminds me of the Peter Pan ride at Euro Disney, where you're sitting in this sailboat that takes off above a sprawling model town of glittering lights. It's kind of like the stars have fallen to earth. Network in Rwanda. It's a bit of an unfortunate acronym, as it leads to people calling it the missing telephone network when it isn't working properly.
Get up.
a van carrying mattresses. Cool piece of street art. As from now on, we're no longer together. You walk me home. But before you go, let's stay here in this moment. Pretend that we're not broken and kiss me like you used to do before it all went down. Forget the moon has fallen, forget the On the right, these pretty white flowers are palm flowers. You say you don't want to get in trouble, that you're doing fine cause you got me. I don't want to break your little bubble, but you gotta wake up to reality. Cause I can see in your eyes, your head is full. Everyone in Kigali either lives in Gikondo or has lived there at some point in the past. I've lived in Gikondo twice myself. It's a nice part of town as it's close to the centre but not too busy. This area is called Nyenyeri after the bar on the right, which has been there for as long as I can remember. Nyenyeri means star in Kinyarwanda. We're just speeding up a little bit to get to the top of the hill. because my second house, after I moved out of Kissimmee around 2009, was right behind the mansion we're about to go past. This is actually one of those streets that still looks pretty much like it always did. Down that road on the left, which was a mud road at the time. And this area is called Rujugiro, after this huge mansion, which used to be owned by tobacco tycoon Tribert Rujugiro. But there was a tax scandal and it was requisitioned. It was a hotel for a brief period, and now it appears to be the headquarters of Learning Compass. So this is where our journey ends. Let me know where you'd like to go next.